27 plus thread, probably the last thread I'm going to make for a while. I'm quitting my wage slave job, it pays too little and I've developed old man pains in my body from it. I've been in retail wage slavery for nearly a decade and it's finally worn me down. I'm gonna sign on and claim an EET bucks, £300 a month, if I even get that is not much, but I want to know from the neat veterans among you how you are able to stretch that at other EET bucks, or if you've figured out ways to earn money from home or have APS asterisk I've income. Maybe I can learn, try and learn Java in the meantime to get job that isn't customer facing. Are you meaning to talk about GBP or are you looking for American EET bucks? GBP. Quote, maybe I can learn, try and learn Java in the meantime. I'm not exactly a part of those STEM circles, at least not anymore since I tried getting into it years and years ago, but I keep seeing bits and pieces of posts here and there talking about how anything that STEM related is a dumpster fire where everyone has a degree or experience and they've spent the last 10-15 years studying and working on whatever it is they do, but no one is hiring because it's almost all being outsourced to India or Taiwan or whatever. Like what manufacturing went through in the 80s and 90s. I'm not sure what your old job was that it gave you old man pains, but being a NEET had a bigger toll on my body and health than any other job I worked. Even with the comfort of living with mommy and daddy and getting free groceries and even some spending money here and there, being a NEET was just awful. For me, money was really the issue. It was the whole, well, what the F asterisk do I do now existential dread. This is why I joined the army unironically. That's why I'm getting a useless JAZ asterisk degree and teaching English in Japan. 0.10% for sure there's gonna reach a point where the whole TESL in Asia bubble finally bursts as well, but it hasn't reached that point yet. I've been NEET in between uni, fat lot of good that did me and jobs, and I understand the depressing nature of being NEET, but good god, retail wage slavery has made me hate people, and not just on an individual level of being complete B asterisk S, but on a societal level. Like where I work, there's loads of office workers, tourists and basically people with money, and every break time I watch these people carry around expensive shopping bags, stepping over the homeless people or waiting in a queue for an ATM machine next to a homeless guy selling the big issue and ignoring him. I don't know why it grinds my gears so much that in I resin TW asterisk shame young people. Quote, I've been NEET in between uni, fat lot of good that did me and jobs. I was a NEET for 6 years, and yes, I also worked wage slavery, and I've seen the very worst from the very worst kinds of people, all the while making the very worst kind of money. Working fast food especially is always such a hellish experience, even on the best of days. There's something about when food is involved that people turn into wild animals, even if they're otherwise the nicest people on earth. But you know what, as bad as all that was and still is, being a NEET was worse for me. Being a NEET is cool when you can measure your time spent as a NEET in months. When you're measuring in years, you're starting to realize that you've been building your own S asterisk time metaphorical coffin. You couldn't even build your own literal coffin cause you were too busy fun posting on this place 18 hours a day. Quote, I was a NEET for 6 years, the hell were you doing for 6 years? Sitting on my computer. Quote, fun posting on this place 18 hours a day, I'm not sure if a fun posting on 4chan is so fun anymore. How did you get out of NEETdom after 6 years? People aren't homeless because other people work to get high-paying jobs and are able to use an ATM, while homeless people squat asking for money instead of a job. This is the problem, you believe those people are homeless because of some systemic suppression instead of the reality, which is they have a mental illness or are a drug addict. Do you enjoy being a Jew? Why don't you go split your paycheck with the homeless then, you commie F asterisk? I give what little I can and I pay my taxes. I hope you burn in hell. I'm not a Jew, but I have nothing against them and watch Ben Shapiro daily. I am a person raised by a single mom who only ever worked minimum wage jobs. I dropped out of high school in the 9th grade. I later got my life together, graduated college with honors and a nursing degree. I've spent my career helping people and sent money monthly to a child in Kenya. My wife donates tithes to her church and is also a nurse. I have come from up from poverty without government as asterisk assistance or charity. If you like socialism so much, go love in Venezuela, you commie F asterisk. Took you a while to think up that bull SH asterisk, didn't it? I do love a bit of socialism, thank God that the UK still has it. I went to school for CS and companies were begging me to work for them after I graduated. Everyone needs developers. Learn .NET instead of Java, it's a bit easier and more jobs nowadays. Is it worth paying to do CS in uni? Where are you based? quote, get date with girl I met through mutual friends. I'm 27, she's 24. We go to a local bar grill that has live music and get dinner. Everything goes well. Take her back to her apartment. Ask if she'd like to do something again next week. She says, yay, tonight was great and she's looking forward to it. Cancels the night before day two. Ask if she'd like to reschedule. Tells me sorry and she doesn't think it's going to work out with us. Tell her, right, that's fine. If it's not meant to be, then it's not meant to be. Ask if she'd share one thing with me. Was it anything about me that made her change her mind? I'm not going to be offended or hurt. Just always looking to improve and maybe you'll have better luck with the next gal. She tells me that she didn't like that I dropped out of college. Closing parenthesis. She worked hard for her degree and had a hard time imagining herself long-term with someone that wasn't also educated. No education also meant less career opportunity and she was looking for someone interested in moving higher up in the world. Many things I wanted to say but I just wrapped it up with thanks for the honesty and good luck the future and deleted her number UF asterisking what? You have a communications degree and work for 30k per year as a secretary that by your own admission had no responsibilities beyond answering the phone and operating a fax machine. I thought I was doing just goddamn fine at 75k per year, but F asterisk me, I guess. Quote, I'm not going to be offended or hurt this entire vent post LMAO. It's an answer at least. W is asterisk Asian. Nah, she was white. Not a need, but check Boris cooking videos online. They are pretty solid if you're willing to put your back into cooking. For that matter, YouTube probably has tons more videos too that are loaded with good tips to make $15 carry you through a week's meals. I've been creating P's asterisk I've income from real estate investments for over a decade now. It's been very good to me. Ask me anything. How did you get to that position? I just worked a software job and started buying houses. Then I branched out to other forms of REIT like debt buying, funds, apartment block shares, etc. I'm still not done with my journey, but I just updated my investment spreadsheet and I'm at the six-figure mark. An excellent result, but oh my F asterisk, it was hard. There's a reason you want to go beyond THR six-figure mark. A few reasons. I've still got some bonuses I want to collect at work. My portfolio isn't structured the way I want, plus risk mitigation, blah blah. I'd like to get to seven figures a year like some folks I know, but just working a regular day job probably won't get me there. But is there a reason beyond just more money? Yes, as I said, there are practical issues around job timing and risk mitigation, income stabilization too. If I simply wanted to increase my pie, I'd take on more debt and leverage my gains up. But that also increases risk, etc. The bigger picture here, the end goal is for me to be able to take some time off from my job soon. My industry has been good to me, but I need to spread my wings, start enjoying the fruits of my labor, and perhaps find an encore career after some self-reflection. That's my big why, my driving reason to accomplish all of this. How's your personal life doing? It's okay, I'd say. I'm not a big social butterfly and I work at home, so very few co-workers, but the real estate stuff is a very people-oriented thing, so I'm often going to after-work events and other meetings to talk with people, look at properties, etc. I'd definitely like to be more of a party animal, but I don't have that much time left before I pull the pin on my job, so I have to keep my eyes on the prize, and as a result, I hang out a lot with other busy aggressive people too. I feel like once I've nailed things down, though, and the summer comes around, the pool in my complex will open and so there's going to be more chilling out and enjoying life. Not really a path for us wage slaves, is it? It's called landlording, and it's a wicked, perverted system that piggybacks off of feudalism without any of the benefits that feudalism provided. Rent seekers go to hell, unironically. Reveal to me the secrets of P's asterisk I've income, boys. I just can't handle wage slaving anymore. Even if it's a small amount monthly, please, I have to escape from Mr. Schekelberg. You see, in asterisk ways, invest in crypto. Which crypto to invest it and how much? Well, you have to determine that for yourself with research and planning. Nothing is ever certain, you take the risk upon yourself, and I'm in no position to tell you how to manage your own risk. But if you are determined to escape wage slavery, then it will be worthwhile. No. Sounds like a scam. If you don't put the work in, you don't get the cash. Simple as, nobody is going to spoon feed you this S. You sound like a scammer. You sound like AR asterisk. Too late for that. Quote, YouTube clickbait thumbnail really an asterisk. I know, there's a lot of garbage out there about basically scams, but I'm kind of a fan of Graham and his stuff about P's asterisk. I've income is legitimate and matches my own experiences. I'm the real estate guy that commented earlier in the thread. Even porn is getting me down. I don't think I have a good income to start building P is asterisk I've income anyway. 28 Why? Oh, neat here. Life is great if your parents aren't psychos. I'm getting comfy S asterisk coding Java and C fizz buzz. All the while drinking beer encouraged by my dad himself. He is always showing me B asterisk S on Facebook to bang. R8. Quote, pound, don't they force you to join group programs or do things like CSCS where you spend the same amount of hours around strangers as you would at work anyway? I think that's after 6 months, but Jesus Christ, I can't do wage slavery with such as asterisk head customers anymore, and there's always the non-zero potential of me being as asterisk courted by customer. I've already had some yob throw a cup of Sprite at me and then tried to goad me into fight from a distance. Do you have any alternatives that don't require a small sum of money to start passive income? I need the money to whiten my teeth. Test. Filtered. I have everything but a girl to call my own, and F asterisk dating at this age, Jesus F in Christ holy S. I think dating these days is school as hell, dude. Foo asterisk going back to being physically limited by what school you go to and whatever places you went to and things you did. Like, you could only think about asking out the girls in CL as asterisk and the girls who take karate CL as asterisk S with you or whatever. There's no girls to ask out on your phone because stuff like Tinder or even Facebook and smartphones don't exist yet. The internet only exists on a computer in your living room and there's almost no girls online. Trips of truth, but still I only attract crazy women. Blee. If you're anything like me, you were also attracting crazy women as a teen, but you didn't see it back then cause you were a teen as well and they were hot enough to distract from it. TBH, it's easier to filter out undesirable girls IRL. Like, they're invisible to me and my FA asterisk IRL is visibly SJW crazy. I just keep my distance online. You only get pictures. Tinder, Bumble, etc. will not tell you why FA IRL as either daddy issues, is a closet lesbian, is crazy, has one pinky, unless you waste your time going on that first date and reading her body language. F asterisk all that. I'd rather be back in the days when online dating was just for dorks and cat ladies. Yeah, me too. As a guy at 20, it's F asterisk in hell trying to date. I ain't one of these desperate guys also who put up with the BS bull SH and games, so I immediately cut a lot of girls off, but I'm not getting dates either. In fact, it's been 4 years since my last date. Quote, yeah, me too. As a guy at 20, I don't think your balls had even dropped when that was a thing. There's still plenty of ugly R asterisk S online, hell is more than ever before. There's still plenty of ugly R asterisk S online, hell is more than ever before. Do you want to try? How old are you? I'm 28, and I actually am trying currently, just feel like I do everything wrong though. Sucks, man. We are probably too far away from each other, but if you want to you, we can talk ANSC where it goes. Sure, I could use somebody to talk to. We can talk on Discord if you have one. Vefume number 4554. I'm as asterisk ooming your different femanins, but do you mind telling us a bit about yourselves? I'm always curious about how older femanins got onto this place. How do I convince my dad that just because I'm a verbal autist doesn't mean that I'm normal and all the issues I have with life are just me pretending so I don't have to work? Tell your dad he failed as a parent. Getting a real diagnosis would be a start unless you have papers from a professional to show. He's right to feel skeptic. If you have the papers to prove it and he's in denial, he's an idiot and I would break relations with him. Sir, I followed the plan and nearing 30 now, I got everything that I was told I would have a place of my own, education, career, more money than I know what to do with. Why does it feel still so empty? I feel the days escaping and there is nothing I can do about it. I wish I could relive every day and not have time go away, growing more and more motivated with each day to give up on women altogether as well. I sometimes wonder what are the chances of being one of the few who might never find a partner, and with every year I see more and more of my friends finding their love while I only seem to regress back. At least I know this pain will end sometime soon. I love reading about people who suck societies de asterisk suffering. There's supposed to be a recession around the corner, right? I hope so. I hope for 80% and more becoming jobless so I don't have to work neither. F asterisk work. I have no free time and only do stupid tasks. I feel like an old man. Quote, soon misery has a way of extending your suffering. Bumping for more NEET bucksteps. At this point I'm guessing I'm 12 years too late to put money into cryptocurrency. No, you're exactly at the right time. Halving soon and alts can give you 10% daily. quote, collect any ET bucks, start a bankroll, find a game to take advantage of, just that easy, fellas. As in poker. Poker, card counting, sports A asterisk, YTICS, horse races. Nearly everything can be advantage played. Seems like a good way to lose money. That certainly can happen. Understanding how to manage risk of ruin is important. At around 20k you can keep it around 5%. This is extremely high and still do very well in a given year. Can't do this in the US unless you live in certain states. Had a good life up until getting married, dating for 3 years before that. He then took me with him to 3 different counties in the span of 5 years, none of which I could work full-time in at first. My career went full freelance and I teach English on the side. Now we're 31 and instead of having kids, he decided this is a great time to divorce instead. I'm gonna be stuck with a big gap in my CV and no dating experience past school. Basically, I'm gonna be a cool wine aunt anyway, even though I tried to do everything right. Quote, now we're 31 and instead of having kids, he decided this is a great time to divorce instead. I'm gonna be stuck with a big gap in my CV and no dating experience past school, ouch. I'm as asterisk ooming your different feminines, but do you mind telling us a bit about yourselves? I'm always curious about how old a feminines got onto this place. 28 professionally, things are going great for me. I changed careers when I was 25, and now I'm on a very solid track toward my dream career. However, mentally I feel like as asterisk. I'm always extremely stressed and depressed. I have nightmares nightly as well. Get a girlfriend so she ca cuddle you. I have a GF but it's long distance, which, that wasn't a problem at first because we could video call every day and we would visit every few months. But now because of schedules, that's become very difficult. Do you have in mind a date when you two will be finally together? When you're waiting for something, time goes faster and you are more motivated. We haven't set a date, but we're going to take another trip together this summer. Let that summer trip be a driving force for your motivation. Having a calendar I cross days on is very satisfying and helps me not get lost in my emotions. It's hard for me to think like that because I don't feel like we talk enough anymore and it's so far. I just feel bad. Dude, I was waiting for the last Jedi past 2 years and got literal garbage. You can still hype it up and be positive around that date. Nothing as bad as TROS can ever happen with you anyway. Yeah, I know. I still feel like S asterisk though. I'm very tired of nightmares every night. I have nightmares only when I'm in an active phase of sleep. Maybe you wake up at night often. Yes, I do. Anyone currently on UK NET bucks?